So to the men's individual kayak final, over 500 meters, and two men in this field looking to become double Olympic gold medalists at these games. Knut Holmann of Norway, successful in the individual kayak final 24 hours ago, over 1,000 meters, and Antonio Rossi with his partner Daniel Scarpa, who took the kayak double over 1,000 meters yesterday. These two men, though, will not have it all their own way. Up against them, last year's world champion, Piotr Markiewicz of Poland, and also the Olympic champion from 1992, Mikko Kolehmainen of Finland. And for good measure, we've got Lutz, Liwowski, who I think has a real chance of grabbing a medal for Germany. But here in lane number one, which will be close to you, is Cameron McFadzean of Australia. From Miami in Australia. Lane two occupied by Miguel Garcia of Spain, who was fifth in the K4 1000s yesterday. Lane number three, this is the very good Romanian Geza, Magyar, who was third in the world 12 months ago. Here's Lutzowski, who just missed a medal in the individual K1, just denied by Clint Robinson of Australia yesterday. Now Antonio Rossi from Lecco, who's been pretty consistent this year. And now Knut Holmann, 28 years of age, with a huge Norwegian fan club here to see whether this man from Bærum can make it two out of two. The man who's going to try and stop him, the Olympic champion in your picture now, Mikko Kolehmainen, who's trained out here for 4 or 5 months. Then Robert Erban of Slovakia. Slovakia still looking for their medal here at the Sprint Regatta. And in lane number nine, farthest away from you, the world champion last year in Duisburg, and that's 22-year-old Piotr Markiewicz. Those are your nine finalists, closest to you Australia, furthest away Poland, the favourites drawn on the echelon in the centre of the course. 500 metres, fast and furious. Two men in with a chance of double glory at the 96 Centennial Games. And Lutzowski in the pink boat for Germany, very quick alongside him. Also Italy's Rossi, and you can't afford to get left behind in this race. Going very quickly is also the Romanian Geza Magyar from Bucharest, the 23-year-old, and he's got the first call on the field. Then Holmann, who usually starts steadily, find his rhythm and watch for him to accelerate, but not wasting time now is Rossi, who's going up on terms with the Romanian. Holmann just lagging back, but don't get too worried about that. Kolehmainen, well, psychologically he's a bit down. The last 2 months of training haven't gone as well as he'd hoped, and arguably he might be one of many at this Games who's overtrained. Coming down already to 250 metres, and it's Rossi of Italy who's ahead of Liwowski, ahead of the Romanian, and Holman's just about fourth at the moment as he looks for double. So the K2 gold medalist of yesterday leads the pack, and Holmann now beginning to get contact with him, but he's got to start moving as we come down. We're just about 150 to go now. Rossi making the best of his way home, but Holmann at the moment is not making an impression on him, and no one else is on the far side. Also the pole, the world champion, beginning to close at the moment, but here they come down into the final 50 meters. Look at the pole, top left on your screen there. He hasn't got to the Italian yet, but he's trying really hard. Markiewicz, who was fourth in the Polish K4 24 hours ago, he's still not got on terms. The angle is very deceptive. It's still Rossi with Holmann coming, and the coverage is there, but Rossi is the double gold medalist. Holmann gets silver, and Markiewicz, the world champion, gets the bronze medal. They let him get away, and they paid the penalty. So Rossi of Italy, the Norwegians, there's Ragnhild. She's here with Knut's dad, Bjorn. They were hoping that their young man could give them double gold, but as it is, it's Antonio Rossi for Italy who triumphs there. And Lutz Liwowski looking to be in just about fourth or fifth place. He was fourth yesterday in the K1. And the promising German just missing his opportunity. But look at Rossi, relaxed, cool, and enjoying it. One of many to take double gold. Most of the attention has been on the likes of Marie Jose Perec and Michael Johnson, who collected double gold. But here's a double gold medalist in the Canoe Sprint Olympic Regatta of 1996. Tremendous performance. Rossi, who won double world gold last year, and he won it with great ease.